हाय फ्रेंड्स, आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू अ लीगल डिक्टेशन एट द स्पीड ऑफ 120 वर्ड्स पर मिनट. लास्ट 3 सेकेंड्स. 1 2 3 स्टार्ट. द अपीलेंट हैड सॉट क्वैशिंग ऑफ द चार्जशीट ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट द एलिगेशन डज नॉट मेक आउट एन ऑफेंस अंडर द एक्ट अगेंस्ट द अपीलेंट मेयरली बिकॉज रिस्पोंडेंट नंबर 2 वॉज ए शेड्यूल्ड कास्ट सिंस द प्रॉपर्टी डिस्प्यूट was not an account of the fact that respondent number 2 was a scheduled caste. The property dispute between a vulnerable section of the society and a person of upper caste will not disclose any offense under the act unless the allegations are on account of the victim being a scheduled caste. Still further, the finding that the appellant was aware of the caste of the informant is wholly inconsequential as the knowledge does not bar any person to protect his rights by way of a procedure established by law. This court in a judgment reported as Ishwar Pratap Singh and others versus State of Uttar Pradesh and another 2018-13 SCC 612 held that there is no prohibition under the law for questioning the charge sheet in part. In a petition filed under section 482 of the code, the High Court is required to examine as to whether its intervention is required for prevention of abuse of process of law for or otherwise to secure the ends of justice. The court held as under having regard to the settled legal position on external interference in investigation and the specific facts of this case. We are of the view that the High Court ought to have exercised its jurisdiction under Section 482 CRPC 1973 to secure the ends of justice. There is no prohibition under law for quashing a charge sheet in part. A person may be accused of several offences under different penal statutes as in the instant case. He could be aggrieved of prosecution only on a particular charge or charges on any ground available to him in law under Section 482. All that the High Court is required to examine is whether its intervention is required for implementing orders under the Criminal Procedure Code or for prevention of abuse of process or otherwise to secure the ends of justice. A charge sheet filed at the dictate of somebody other than the police would amount to abuse of the process of law, and hence the High Court ought to have exercised its inherent powers under Section 482 to the extent of the abuse. There is no requirement that the charge sheet has to be quashed as a whole and not in part. Accordingly, this appeal is allowed. The supplementary report filed by the police at the direction of the commission is quashed. In view of the above facts, we find that the charges against the appellant under Section 31R of the Act are not made out. Consequently, the charge sheet to that extent is quashed. The appeal is disposed of. In the above terms, the FIR in respect of other offences will be tried by the competent court in accordance with law, along with the criminal case 11, though separately initiated for the reason that it relates to inter-party dispute and is in respect of same subject matter of property. Despite of the fact that two different dates of the incident have been provided by the parties. Stop.